Good morning and welcome to our teacher training for our children's Sunday school. This is for the year 2021-22, and I'm so thankful that you are here this morning to watch our training video and also for your willingness to be part of our children's ministry here at First Pres. For your willingness and your devotion to our children, I greatly appreciate it, and I hope that today you will find this helpful, beneficial, and meaningful as you begin to prepare for this upcoming year with Sunday school. I'm doing this training via Zoom so that you can see all of the components. I'm going to share my screen so that you can see our PowerPoint and also can see our leader guide and our different activity pages all on the screen through our PDF files. All of this will be accessible to you. So if you'd like to see all of these things, even more so than the attachments that I shared in the email with you, you can have access to all of this, and all of these things will be in your classroom as well when you get ready to teach. So let's just dive right in. I'm going to share my screen. All right. So we are using Celebrate Wonder as our curriculum. Deep Blue was our curriculum that we used prior to Celebrate Wonder. They discontinued that, and Cokesbury, after Deep Blue, created Celebrate Wonder, and I began to use this last year during our pandemic, and I used it throughout our Zoom Sunday schools. I've used it through the spring and summer when we've had in-person Sunday school. Also used this throughout the year last year for our weekday school chapel videos. And I have really enjoyed this curriculum. I love the stories and the way that they incorporate wonder and exploration and truly allowing children to see and to understand the presence and the awe of God. So we have Celebrate Wonder. And why Celebrate Wonder? It encourages our open-ended exploration of the Bible. We know that we can, as adults, read a story in Scripture 4, 5, 6 times, and depending on our own life circumstances, we might resonate with a different part each and every time that we come to it. Or, like I teach the children with parables, we can read a parable over and over and over again, and one day it might just all of a sudden make sense. We want the same kind of open-ended exploration to happen with each story as the children, as they come to Sunday school, as they learn, as they read and grow, as they do activities, all those pieces of this curriculum allow that exploration. It also allows for engaging conversations between you and the children. Their questions are not just cut and dry, answer, question, answer, and move on. There are lots of wonder questions, lots of questions that expand so that children can explore and engage in that and move beyond just the what happened, the who it was, the where it was. It's why, how they felt, how can you connect and relate to it? Truly builds that engaging conversation. And it also provides a safe space to wonder. We allow our children to wonder. I always remind them in the classroom, there's no right or wrong answer. You might see God in a place that somebody else maybe didn't, but they may see God in a different part of the story. And we're all allowed to have that same sense of wonder together. And I love that about this curriculum. It's based on spiritual practices of play, discovery, biblical exploration, faith conversion, and relationship. This curriculum has truly been able to incorporate all of those pieces so that the kids are able to play and discover, to explore, to grow deeper in their faith, and also have a deeper relationship with you and a deeper relationship with God. All of those components are part of this. When you think of your main components, the first one we have is our spiritual practice. That is the intentional activity, the intentional rituals that we do that help us become aware of God's presence. And for children, that's tangible, hands-on activities. And so this curriculum allows for that to happen. Whether it's watching the video, reading the story, having the wonder box, the wonder cube, having the activities that are hands-on, those are all part that allow them to truly feel God's presence. We have a peaceful place, and that's a place where they can spend a quiet time with God. They it's a part of your classroom that you can create yourself, and you can put in there for the children to go if they need to have a moment just to be quiet, to be still with God. You can have that built into your classroom. The third is the wonder table. You can create this in your classroom as well. We have this in the Red Door room where I'm sitting right now, and it's part of the room that I have set up here, but it allows for them to come and they can see the liturgical calendar. They can see the table, and have a sense of where you might have your bread and your cup there. You might have a cross. Those elements in your room that just allow children to continue to see the liturgical parts of worship and bring them into your own classroom. So they can see it in your classroom and they can see it in their worship spaces. You have the wonder box. I have actually used it as a wonder basket. I have a large basket that I use, but each week you have an item that's inside the basket or the box. And in that, they are there's an item that relates to the story. You pull that out and then you have the chance to wonder and figure out how they correlate to the story. And they're very fun to use. We also have the monthly faith words. You'll see in just a second with the scope and sequence that got Celebrate Wonder is broken down into units there by month. And each month you have your faith word and every lesson goes along with that. I'll show you this a little closer in a second, but you can see here all 12 units with each unit, every lesson that's broken down underneath. And so it goes through the entire year, 4 lessons or 5 lessons, depending on how many weeks there are in the month. But you have all of that there to use. All right, I'm going to stop sharing my screen for a second. Let's look at our lesson overview. I'm going to pull up our leader guide so that you have the opportunity to see what a lesson looks like. These are similar to the layout of our deep blue we had a couple years ago. So if you've taught in the past few years, you'll see it's similar, but not exactly the same. I want to break down each piece for you so that you can see that. Here you can see our scope and sequence a little closer. So you see each one, you have the unit word. So like for September of this year, our first unit is reconciliation. Each story in the month of September is about Joseph. And so every lesson will encompass that word, and you'll have the lesson session video. The questions will relate to that faith word. So you're continuing to build in that word throughout the month. There's also a unit Bible verse that you will each week encourage the children to find in their Bibles, to memorize, to learn. There's a poster that goes along with that for each month, so you can have that as well. And you can reinforce reconciliation, the faith word. You can reinforce the Bible verse and how they all come together with the lessons. Here you can see just the basic outline of each unit, each lesson, and where they begin. You can have, you will have access to this leader guide on the Google Drive, so that you can see this beforehand, but they will also be in your classroom in your Sunday school room so that you can see that. I will show you now before we get into the actual lesson. We have 2 Bibles. Like I said, the deep blue is our common English Bible. They're the same Bible, but it has the Celebrate Wonder logo on the bottom. It also has some good wonder questions and other pieces that will enhance your lesson. These are upstairs in our classroom, so you can use these for your lessons. Our first graders last year also received this Bible with their Bible presentation. So some of them already have this and can use this. So our elementary students will have this Bible they can use. Either they bring with them or they have this in your classroom. Our preschoolers have a Celebrate Wonder Bible storybook. I love this storybook. It's so colorful. They're The Bible stories are broken down in simple ways for the kids to see. Also love that it has a wonder question. So each lesson, the kids can have some sense of wonder just to enhance their learning. Our Rising 3K students, boys and girls, will get this at the beginning of this this year on Rally Day. And so you'll have, the preschoolers will have this book, this Bible storybook, and the elementary will use the other. Okay, so with your lesson guide, each session begins with your chance to prepare to wonder. It has your faith word at the top, so you see that, and it has a brief overview of the lesson for the week so that you're able to see that. It also has a spiritual practice for the adults. I have enjoyed reading these as I have prepared myself to teach. It has a great spiritual practice that you as an adult can use yourself, that then will also enhance your lesson as you begin to teach. They're very simple, easy to use, but I found them very, very meaningful. The next part is called Come Together, and this is when you have children coming into your classroom at the beginning of each Sunday school. This would take place for elementary in the Red Door Room when they gather all together at the beginning of their time. You will see where it's broken down by age group. You have the preschool, younger elementary, older elementary, and then you also have all ages that you can see there. This is different than before. We used to have a preschool lesson, a younger elementary, a middle elementary, and an older elementary. Now all the lessons are the same, and you can incorporate different pieces based on the ages that you are teaching. You will have access to all of these pages in the reproducible kids book. So if you have multiple ages, you can have all different activities. In the Red Door Room, I might have different tables with different age group pages, and the kids can just come and pick whatever they would like to do as they're coming in to the space. But those beginning come together activities all feed into your lesson. Then you have your wonder time. This is where you would watch the session video. We have the DVD downstairs for preschool and the DVD upstairs in here in the Red Door Room for elementary. After they watch the video together, that's when you will have time to wonder together in your class as your small group. You'll read the Bible story together. You can use the Wonder Story Mat and the Wonder Story Images. These are all part of the class pack that you have access to. Here are the little characters for the Joseph stories, and they will be all used for all four lessons for September. So they're broken down by unit. You have these that you can use and cut out, and that enhances your lesson as you're teaching younger children. You also have the time to wonder together. You see here, it has a wonder question. You also have the wonder box, the wonder basket, as I used, and there it is. So like for the first lesson, you would have a robe. It might be a picture of a robe. It could be an actual robe that you bring yourself. You can, and you'll pull that out and you'll talk to the children about how that correlates to the story. One component that they had before, in last year, before they kind of tweaked it a little bit, was called the Wonder Cube. That we also have access to. It's not in our lessons, but this is the time to use that, and our children really enjoy it. I have found it a great tool to enhance the conversations. There are six questions on this Wonder Cube, and so the children just get to roll it, read the question out, and then you can talk about it. And that's where I really found that some children, you begin to see where they learn and they build their own faith. I wonder what you would change about the story. I wonder what your favorite part was. I wonder what did the story teach you. I wonder where you saw God in the story. What is the most important part? I wonder if you could be any character in the Bible story, what character would you be and why? truly allows for that engaging conversation. And so I love to have these. These will be in your room, and there are extra copies if children would like to have one to take home and make their own Wonder Cube. This is a great part of the lesson. The next piece is called Experience Wonder. This is where you have your activities that you can do together. There's a game or some activity, hands-on activity that you can do together. You can examine the monthly Bible verse. That's where you'll do that every week. This is where you can have the peaceful place. This is where your kids can have the chance to do their own activity. In our godly playroom, we have it, we call it our work time, and our kids can go and they can do their own work. Maybe it's coloring a picture, maybe it's working with a story, maybe it's reading the Bible story themselves. This is not mandatory, but I have seen such growth, and I love watching our children incorporating that time into their own spiritual practice. And so if you can incorporate this and have a space in your room that kids can have a peaceful place, it really does enhance their own growth and their own chance to learn. So it gives you a variety of things that you can do. You can give them a piece of paper and have them draw their favorite story, part of the story. You can have them color the faith word. This is all optional, but like I said, I would incorporate this into your class so that you have that option for children to do that. Go in peace is the very ending, the last component of our lesson. This is where you'll give the kids their take-home information. There's a take-home guide, a family letter, an activity. I'll show you those in just a moment, but you can take these all home and they can practice this. And this is all optional if you have time in your lesson. We also have other supplemental activities that you can incorporate into your lesson if you need. It's all, they give you tons of information, tons of activities, and you can pick and choose based on the children that you have, your age groups, and how much time you actually have in your lessons. So it's really something that you can use and incorporate in your own way. I'm gonna scroll down and show you. So here are the supplemental activities. Again, based on age group, you have your preschoolers, you have your early elementary, you have your older elementary. You also have the intergenerational activity if you had all groups together. So you can see there, you have your activity, your page, wonder question, something to say. So it's very easy to follow, to grab, and to learn how to use. I'm going to scroll down to the bottom so you can see some extra activities that and information to use. This is called the Celebrate Chart. And you give this to the children, they take this home, and throughout the week, if they do any of these activities, they can cross it off like a bingo game. They can bring it back. This gives you a chance on a weekly basis to talk about where they, you know, celebrated, where they showed peace, where they saw God, where they wondered about the story, where they prayed. Continuing that engagement after they leave on a Sunday and while they're at home during the week. So that is something that you can pass out to the children. You also have a family letter that can go home. This family letter talks about what they're going to be learning throughout the units and gives them some ideas of things to do together, which is a great thing, another tool to give to parents. We know that we are not the main spiritual leaders for these children. The main spiritual growth happens at home. We want to give them the tools and the resources to use to make that happen, to make that accessible at home, so that moms and dads are those people who are giving them that main spiritual guide. We are here to support and enhance that. So you can give them that information. You have your faith word. So here are your faith word coloring pages that you can use each unit. You also have at the very end of a leader guide, different varieties of ways that you can use this curriculum. One room ministry, age graded ministry, which we have some of that. We also mostly use this model, large group, small group, where we start with the large group in the elementary, have them all together, and then break off into small group, their age group classes, and have their time together to read the story, to do the activities. That's mostly what we have here. Also had the intergenerational. If you had all ages, children and youth and adults all in one, this would be something that you could do. This is also an option if, for some reason, with the pandemic, not knowing how things are, if it had to go back to where children had to have Sunday school at home, this gives you an idea and a way that you can help incorporate this and use this virtually with our children. So that is an option too. This is all part of the very end of the leader guide. So I wanted you to know about that. All right, let me share with you now our reproducible pages. Each week, you will have these pages, and now they're numbered and labeled by age group. Let me share this screen with you. Okay. So you have your table of contents, and it has each page where it begins, and it shows you what the reproducibles are. So you have 5 pages per lesson, A, B, C, D, E. The number is correlates with the lesson, and then you have A is preschool, B is younger elementary, C is older elementary, then you have D is a take-home activity, and E is your intergenerational activity. So I'm going to show you those now. Like I said, you'll have access to all of these. So if you have a variety of ages, you can pick and choose, and you can have them all as an option if you would like. Preschool is going to normally choose the AB. Older elementary might do BC, or which you might choose to have all three. So here's a coloring page. Here's another coloring page that's for older children. Word search that's geared towards older elementary. Here's a home activity that you can send home for this lesson. And then if you had the intergenerational activity, that's something that you could do as well. So you have all of those per with the lesson. I'm going to scroll down and show you. At the very end, you have the answer key if you were to need that. That will be available. And then also, here are the take-home pages. So for each one, at the end of all 13, lessons. At the end of all, 13, you have 2 pages that you can take home. It has a brief overview of the story, and it also has a family spiritual practice. I love that component because there again, it just gives another resource in the hands of parents they can use and do together at home. Also has another activity that families can do together. And so these are wonderful options to make sure that you send home each week with our kids. Families can use those things together to just continue to enhance their understanding of the Bible story and what we're talking about while we're using that. And then on a weekly basis, it continues to enhance and reinforce the monthly themes, all of those components. The next part, we're getting close to the end. I wanted to just share, on top of having all of this information for our for the curriculum and for Sunday school, I also wanted to share with you our 7 safety practices. I know that many of you have used this before. Many of you have seen this, you've gone through the training before, but if you have not, we have to do this annually just to review, to remind ourselves of these practices that we have here at our church to ensure the safety of our children. So I want to go through those now. And at the very end of this, after you've watched this, if you will sign the sheet saying that you have gone through the training again, the first part of it is the clean records practice. We annually have to check backgrounds to make sure that our children are safe and that we all have a clean criminal background. So that is conducted every year. Some of you have already gone through that and sent that in. You will also have to send an authorization form in at the very end so that we can do that. So we'll do that annually. The 6-month practice, we have volunteers that we ask that they have been a member of a church or actively participating for at least 6 months. So it's important for our volunteers, our teachers, our leaders to be active in the church and participating, because we want to teach our children that same value, that same importance. And so we ask that our teachers and volunteers be active members or at least actively participating for at least 6 months. The next is participating in the annual training that you are doing now. Just to go over these safety practices to understand what is expected and how to have the best, ensure the best and safest place for our children on a weekly basis. The 2-adult practice states that at least 2 unrelated adults are present in each group, in each room with children or with youth. That is why we ask that we have a rotating Sunday school class, we have rotating volunteers, and that we have at least 2 in the classroom at all times. For your safety, for their safety, we want to make sure that we have at least 2 unrelated adults in the room. The open door practice is that you as a teacher, a volunteer, you avoid situations where you could be out of sight from other people. So keeping the door open, having the door, if it's not open, having the door with the window. We have all of our doors here have windows in them. So if you had to close them, you have the window there. But we do ask that you keep your door open just so that others can see and hear what's going on, for your safety and for the safety of the children. Hands-off practice, we ask that you limit physical contact with children and youth, keeping it more to pats on the back or the shoulder. We know that children they are hands-on, they love to hug, they love to give high fives, fist bumps, elbow bumps, making sure that whatever you do, I try to encourage my volunteers and nursery workers just to, you know, if you're going to that, hey, I'm going to give you a hug. Is that okay? Oh, you want a hug? Or, hey, high five. Just making it verbal so that somebody else can hear what you are doing, and just to ensure that everybody is aware of situation. But limiting your physical contact with them. The last is requiring reported practice. If you see any sign of injury or any possible abuse, immediately report it. Please report it as soon as possible to Craig, to one of the other pastors, somebody on staff, so that we can get that information. We are required to follow up on that and report it if we see or we hear of abuse. So please, as a volunteer, if you see any signs of that, you are required to report that to us so that that can be reported to the appropriate officials. Like I said, this is part of our annual review. are finishing this, if you will sign that 7 safety practice page that's attached and return this to us so that we have record of this, we have to have this annually. Like I said, with the annual background check, we also have to have your annual background. So if you will fill this out, you can put it in an envelope, return it in Craig's box, in Shannon's box. You can put it in Lanise Clark's box. She's the one that takes it, fills the information into the information for the background check, and then she shreds it. So it does not stay here. If you're worried about that, this information goes into the system. Once everything is clear, she shreds it. It's never around anymore. So if you will fill those out and return those to us so that we can have record of that. If you have already filled that out and have already gone through the background check process earlier in the summer, you don't have to do that right now. You can wait. We're just doing this. We're trying to get on an annual basis. And so every August, we will try to re-up those to make sure that we have everybody with updated background checks, updated 7 safety practices, just to make sure that we're all doing what we can to ensure the safety of our children here at First Pres. If you have any questions about the curriculum, if you have any questions about your class or what you might need, please be sure to, don't hesitate, be sure to reach out. You can ask me any questions if you'd like to see more information about the curriculum or have other information, questions about background check or 7 safety practices. Please be sure to give me a call or crack a call. We would love to have to help you however we can. We want to ensure that you have all that you need to make sure that Sunday school is a wonderful experience, that when children come here on a Sunday morning, that they are excited to learn and that they feel that same excitement and they can feel God's presence all around. So thank you for being here. I appreciate your time. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to call, and I will see you soon. Bye.